Now we're on to the third picking pattern in the top 10 picking patterns that I think are most important for someone to learn when you're wanting to get into picking patterns. These are varied picking patterns with lots of different styles, and I would start with these in the order that I'm suggesting here. The third pattern is going to be a 4-1 together, then we're going to play 3-2 and 4-1-3-2. So we're playing the same notes, but the first time we play it through, we're playing the first two notes together. So it's going to be 4-1-3-2, 4-1-3-2, 4-1-3-2, 4-1-3-2. And we count this 1-2-3-4, and 1-2-3-4, and. So we're actually skipping a beat in our pattern. In the past, we've said 1-2-3-4, and with the first pattern that I taught you in week one, it was 1-2-3-4, and. We played all of those notes. We went like this, 4-2-3-1, so it was 1-2-3-4, and like that. But now we're doing a 1-2-3-4, and 1-2-3-4, and. So it adds a little bit of complexity if you're new to finger picking because you're skipping a beat. So it'll require you to isolate the right hand like we've talked about in the previous patterns if you have issues. You can play obviously left hand and right hand together at the same time, but I would start with isolating the right hand, getting a metronome out, taking the tempo down to go real slow at whatever tempo is best for you, and then practicing with the 4-1 together, 3-2, 4-1-3-2. So it goes like this. Thumb and second finger are going to pick together first, 4-1, then thumb, then first finger, then thumb and second finger together. Sorry, that's the first time. So the second time it's just 4-1-3-2. So it's thumb, second finger, thumb, first finger. So the first time it goes thumb one together, excuse me, thumb two together, 1-2, thumb two, 1-2. Second time is 4-1-3-2. Together, 3-2-4-1-3-2, 4-1 together, 3-2-4-1-3-2, 4-1 together, 3-2-4-1-3-2, thumb and first finger, excuse me, thumb and second finger, thumb one, thumb two, thumb one, gotta think about it for a second, thumb one, thumb two, thumb. Thumb two, thumb one, thumb two, thumb one, thumb two, thumb one, thumb two, thumb one together, thumb two, thumb one, thumb two, thumb one together, thumb two, thumb one, thumb two, like that. Now we're going to move that same pattern up a string to the five, so it's going to be 5-2-3-4, so 5-2-4-3, 5-2-4-3, 5-2 together, 4-3, 5-2-4-3, 5-2 together, 4-3. Five two four three, five two four three, five two four three, one two and three and four and one two and three and four and one two and three. Now try and add your sixth string here. So ready, switch. So it's 6-2-4-3, 6-2-4-3, 6-2-4-3, 6-2-4. 6-2 together, 4-3, 6-2-4-3. Thumb and second finger, thumb one, thumb two, thumb one. Thumb two together, thumb one, thumb two, thumb one. Okay, so once you've isolated the right finger, the right hand, and the right fingers and the right hand, you will practice that until you have it to where you can play it 9 or 10 times without a struggle. And you want to be able to play these picking patterns to the level that you can think about what you want to eat for dinner while you're practicing them, because that's when you'll be able to strum and sing and pick all at the same time. So if I was going to add the chords to this, I would probably play a G, C, and a D with this if we're in the key of G. So I'm going to just do that right now, starting with the D chord. So 4-1-2-3-4, and like that. And I want to think about, let's see, okay, tonight I'm probably going to have maybe some roast beef or maybe a burger. That'd be pretty good. Or instead, I'm just going to go get pizza at some place. So I can just talk about, or if I'm going to go more healthy, maybe I should have some quinoa or even some sushi. But you need to be able to think about something else while you're practicing this and then switch. Because if you can think about something else, then you can start singing. And because it's kind of two different things here. You've actually got your right hand, then your left hand, which is the chords you're playing, and then you have to think about something totally different with the song. So you kind of have three different things going on, and you have to get good enough where you can play it over and over again, and you start the muscle memory. You'll practice the muscle memory. Your fingers will start to memorize where this pattern is, just by repetition. And a hammer-on, something to think about in the future. I'll show you about how to do the hammer-on in the future, but know that it's a possibility. Five, two, four, three, five, two, four, three, five, two together. And then six string pattern. So it's just 6-2 and then 4-3. 6-2 together, 4-3. Like that. Okay, so that's the pattern. Practice that over and over again, lots of times, and your fingers will get faster. You will improve in that pattern as you isolate it, slow it down, and you slowly increase as you do it correctly. Okay, so that is picking pattern 3. We will go on to number 4 out of 10, and we're doing the top 10 picking patterns that I think are important for you to learn when you're learning to play the guitar. All right, thanks for watching.